Court at the end of this month, so next Thursday is a huge opportunity to highlight the fact that we've been stripped of our rights.
Do you want to tell us why we're here?
Oh yeah, we're doing a strip of our rice stunt today now in Dublin, busy near the Grafton Street. So we hope to get some media coverage. And we actually have a broadcaster from Radio 1 Drive Time coming down interviewing, covering this event as well.
And you were in Government Buildings yesterday? Do you want to talk
to that? I was presenting in the Dáil about the water fluoridation with Declan Waugh, the environmental scientist, and we're invited by Brian Stanley, the TD, who's putting forward a bill to ban fluoride. So hopefully now we're going to start getting some cross-party support. Okay. I think it's going to start being really taken seriously.
Okay, Ashley, thank you very much.
Okay.
That's great, thanks. Why it is we're here?
We're here today to promote the Gunn Against Fluoride campaign.
Okay.
To bring public awareness to the Dublin people so that when the court case comes about next year, that they will actually come out in their droves to support the court case that's been taken against the state.
Okay, and what are you hoping to achieve by this today?
Well, we're hoping for a lot of people, they're not even aware that fluoride is in the water, so that we've got a little competition that people can take part in to win a free water filter. And then you've got the details of the campaign at the back, so it will draw attention for some people for the very first time that fluoride is actually in the water. And it's also, it will bring a lot of young kids on board, with making it pink, fun, and less threatening than just handing out posters that say fluoride is bad for you.
Okay. Yeah. And this has got a lot of media attention, as you can see from all the cameras here. Do you think it's achieving its goal, or...?
I think that the main thing is that when people just get on side one by one, really, today is just a publicity stunt.
Yeah.
It will bring in some people, but for the majority of people, it's one by one. It's one person telling another person, meeting another person, and just talking about it at any opportunity that they can.
Okay,
really.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
In your own time?
Yeah, I'm Aidan Killian, and the reason I'm doing this is I'm not enjoying this. I'm standing here in my underpants in town, and all the people are walking by and they can see me, and I feel absolutely ridiculous. But the reason I'm doing it is because fluoride's got to go, and I don't know how to get it out, so at least I'm doing something. And anyway, the women are really enjoying looking at me.
Okay. Could you tell me what is your name is there, please?
Anti-fluoride man.
And anti-fluoride man, what are your superpowers?
I drink clean, unfluoridated water, and I have super strength, super intelligence. I'm very good with the ladies, and I can fly.
Is there anything you'd like to say to anybody that's here, or
anybody watching? Should contact their local councillor and insist that fluoride get removed from the water, because it is damaging our health. We are suffering. It is contributing to deterioration in general health across the population, and it has to stop now.
Okay, thank you very much, Super Fluoride Man. Tell me who you are and why you're here today.
I'm Magda Tata. I'm from Brazil. I live in Dublin for 7 years. And, you know, I take me 3 years for starting to get kind of used to drink water from the tap here, because it's so clear, you know, that, you know, the fluoride is, you know, like, make the water taste strange, make me sick. Like, many studies showing that it make people sick anyway. So I hope, you know, people realize this. And we are here for making this, okay?
You certainly got a lot of media attention. Thank you very much.
Thank you too.
Tell me who you are and why you're here today.
I'm a photographer for the Press Association. So because we work for a big news agency and the papers rely on our content, this story is a good one because it combines sort of hot weather pictures with a good sort of protest. And Aisling was at the Dáil recently lobbying TDs, and so we can link the photographs of this into that story, you know.
Okay, thanks, Damien. Okay, could you tell me who you are and what it is you have here?
Hi, I'm Christina, and I'm from WeThePeople.ie, and we ran a campaign back in 2006.
Okay.
And this is a letter here from Dublin City Council with regard to the water additives they use to purify the water, in inverted commas. Now, you can see sulfuric acid, aluminium sulfate, hydrofluorosilic acid and chlorine gas.
Okay, and what has been done about this?
Well, we ran a campaign, we did a tap water alert, we've contacted the councils, we've done a lot over the years, but we're being ignored. So we joined in with Aisling's campaign last year, very happily to do that, and we feel that we the people are sovereign, not the executive, so we can write registered letters to our local councils and demand them to remove these additives from our water.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And it's a real shame that I've had to go to such lengths as to have to create this alter ego, the Girl Against Fluoride. And I've had to go all over the country to, you know, perform in different publicity stunts just to get people's attention about such a serious issue that should just be taken up on, you know, on its merit alone.
I'm Kelly, I'm a journalist, former editor of Water and Waste Treatment magazine.
Fluoride.
Only really found out about fluoride after I set up a website for thyroid illness in Ireland, and one of my contributors wrote about how bad fluoride is.
Okay.
It basically stops your thyroid gland functioning, so I've been supporting Aisling since last year. The fluoride basically stops thyroid glands function. There are so many, there are more than 3,000 people who are scientists saying it's ineffective as a preventative for cavities, which is the main reason. It's untested, it's cumulative, it's toxic. How many words can you use to say why this policy is bad? As Brian Stanley said when I interviewed him last week, there is no logic to it. It was brought in 1965,
okay,
when people didn't have access to toothpaste. Our country is very different than it was in 1965. I would like us to get it out before it's 50 years, and I just support everything Aisling and Declan Waugh are doing.
Okay, thank you very much.
A luncheon to help fluoridation of water supplies for Repeal Bill 2013. And what we're doing here today, following about a year of research and looking into this matter, we have decided to bring forward this bill to end the practice of putting fluoridation in the water, in public water supply, in the 26 counties. We believe this is unsafe. We believe there's huge questions over it, from the point of view of health. Fluoride is an acid-based substance. It's a byproduct of the fertilizer industry. We believe that it's unsafe.
And because I've published the report and put it out online, I've had medical experts from all around the world contacting me, and I've got people from 19 countries, probably 20 countries at this stage, who are reading the information that I've put out there. Clinical medical studies had shown that a percentage of the population are intolerant to fluoride. So anything between 46,000 and 200,000 people in Ireland may be intolerant to fluoride. And the way that this may express itself with them is neurological problems, cardiovascular problems, dermatological problems.
We're here today, we've organised a protest at ChihabEK industrial estate. It's the plant anyway that's distributing fluoridation chemicals around the country.
Mm-hmm.
And we're here to highlight the fact that they are actually poisoning our water. Even though they say it's mandated by law, that doesn't matter, that's a policy, but actually they're harming human health by adding these dangerous fluoridation chemicals. And we want to find out, do they have any toxicological data to show it's safe for our human health? And we also want to just use this as a publicity opportunity to get people aware that this is where it's coming from and that something has to happen.
Okay, could you tell me who you are? ChihabEK?
We're ChihabEK, the company that's making and distributing the water fluoridation chemicals. In 2008, their net profit was 12.8 million. So the taxpayers are actually being paid. We're paying to be poisoned.
Okay.
It's not in 98% of Europe. It shouldn't be in our water.
Okay.
and industry is behind this government policy. So there's no point in us talking to the TDs or talking to the councillors. It's industries behind all this, and the lobby groups. This is why we've come here today. Because the lobby groups are the industrial groups.
Okay, no problem. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Okay, and what was your reaction when you first heard about the fluoridation issue?
Shock, disgust, anger, physical sickness when I heard about all the illnesses that come from it. Well, I went to a comedy gig by a guy called Aidan Killian, and he mentioned that it's the only ingredient, it could be the only ingredient in rat poison.
Okay.
And that shocked me. And then I heard it somewhere else again, and I was like, oh my god, this is in our water. That's wrong.
Okay.
My name is Marianne Sleffen. I'm here because I feel very strongly about the fact that we have to drink fluoride. It's in our water, it gets into our food, it gets into pretty much everything. It's very, very hard to escape, and I think it's absolutely horrendous that the Irish population are subjected to this toxic chemical that seems to be so harmful to our health.
Okay, and Aidan, how did you hear about this fluoride issue?
Well, fluoride is something I've always known about because my mum used to filter the tap water, and she used to tell us that fluoride was bad for us and would give us cancer as a kid, so I kind of always knew that. But it seems to become much more of an issue since Aisling and her gang, Steve, and her mum have got involved sharing all the information and the facts with the world to let, well, the Irish people, to let them know what's going on.
Would you have any advice for people who are only learning about the fluoride issue?
I think the best thing, have a look on the website, The Girl Against Fluoride. That's very basic information, because it is, again, it's not a scientific campaign, it is a publicity campaign to raise awareness. But the next thing I'd ask people to do is to go on fluoridealert.org, and you can have a review of that. And also, another brilliant place to go to, if you're confused, is go on to hotpress.com and search fluoride, and you have all the articles they've been writing on the history of fluoride, the political and economical arguments against it. They've interviewed all people from, politicians to Declan Waugh, the environmental scientist, to myself. As in, they have shown how Skibbereen Town Council now passed a motion to end water fluoridation, and how other councils now are now coming on support of this. And really that it's moving now into a mainstream area, and that Brian Stanley also, they covered about his bill that he's trying to put forward in the Dáil to ban fluoride. So hotpress.com, search fluoride, and you'll get a huge wealth of information. If you don't know anything about it, I'd recommend you start there anyway.
Would you have any advice for people just learning about it?
Well, I just asked the basic question, just to have a look at it, see if it's medicinal. Go and check. Is it medicinal, or is it classified as a poison?
Okay.
And then make the decision yourself. If you want it because you believe it's good for your teeth, fine. Go and get fluoride and put it on your teeth. But ask the question, why do we have it forced upon us? It just seems unusual, to say the least.
Okay. Why should people be concerned with fluoride? Why is it an issue?
There's low levels of fluoride in our drinking water, but the thing is, it accumulates over time. And also the fact is, everyone is drinking varying amounts of water. So you can't guarantee the dosage, you can't guarantee the safety of this substance, because we're getting uncontrollable amounts of this in our water. Something that people can relate to easily is that it reduces thyroid function. It impairs your ability to uptake iodine. And it has an impairment for people with kidney disease, that they're not able to excrete it. And also for young babies, it's very risky for making up formula milk for young babies, and there is a very strong risk of people getting dental fluorosis.
Harvard did a study recently about lowering IQ of children.
Okay.
It's linked to cancer, it's linked to diabetes.
After I researched fluoride, I made the conclusion myself that it's not good for us, it is bad for us.
because 98% of Europe don't add fluoride to their drinking water. There's also the Republic of Ireland, 10% of the UK, and the Basque region in Spain. I mean, Holland actually banned it in their constitution in 1976, and other countries that were fluoridating stopped because they saw that it was actually harmful to health. And it's also very unethical because you're mass medicating your whole population without their consent.
Okay, thank you very much. Ireland is the only country to be fluoridated in Europe, is that correct?
It's the only country in Europe to have mandatory fluoridation, where you have to have it. Other countries such as Spain have a very small percentage.
David's the cameraman. We're making a documentary about this whole big fluoride scandal. So what we're going to try and do now, if the gates are open, if we can get in, we're going to go around here and we're going to ask ChemiFlock. Basically, ChemiFlock are the company that import the artificial fluoridation chemicals into the country and sell them to our government, who in turn put them into the water. So we're going to go around and ask them now. Just under EU REACH regulations, they should have carried out risk assessments. So we'd like them to tell us what exact risk assessments they can quote to us. And also have to have public liability insurance for any adverse health effects that may arise in the future.
If I get one person to beep, it'll be a success.
It'll be worth your while.
Beep, you got a score right now. You did it.
Clean water.
Beep if you want clean water.
You got the dirty water.
Hi Brenda, I recognise your voice. I was talking to you a few minutes ago there. Listen, there's some concerned citizens out here and they're not really happy that nobody will come out and speak with them. So maybe if you could just ring me back straight away, please, and maybe we could just organise for... I believe Ed's car is there, so I'm wondering just when he might be free. He might be busy at the moment, but we're prepared to hang around, so maybe if you could give us a buzz back, and we'll be waiting here anyway.
Mm-hmm.
It's just this bunch could turn rowdy like, and
I don't want any trouble. No, I wouldn't say that.
That's
they were making a documentary, and we'd like your opinion.
We're making numerous documentaries actually, Brenda, yeah. So I think there's two or three.
May as well have the opinions of both sides of the story, look,
yeah.
If there is one.
It's unbiased.
So we're looking forward to your official statement, but it would just be nice because people have travelled a long way. People have travelled from all over the country today. So if you could just send someone out, we'd really appreciate if Ed could come out and just have a quick chat with us. And just we've only two or three very basic questions, and it's as simple as that.
What? Your name, number.
Hi Brenda, Stephen Kerr here again. My number is 087-1940203. Thanks for your statement. We've got your statement there. Thanks for that. But there seems to be a couple of inaccuracies with it in terms of the European law. We think that we might be the EU REACH regulations state that maybe actually it needs to have toxicological data. So we just want to know what toxicological data you have, and maybe you could give us a call back and we can discuss it actually. Thanks very much.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Anyway,
yeah, yeah.
We have our own little superhero up and coming.
So thanks to ChemiFlock for this. Friday the 5th of July 2013, ChemiFlock manufactures and supplies water treatment products. In 2007, the HSC awarded ChemiFlock the national contract for the supply of fluorosilicic acid to all water treatment plants in Ireland in accordance with National Fluoridation Programme under Irish law. ChemiFlock does not influence government policy on drinking water. ChemiFlock takes its role in the treatment of water very seriously and complies with all Irish and European standards for chemicals used in the production of drinking water. So I think that's wrong in terms of the European directive.
They don't use fluoride in Europe.
No. We'll know about that in a minute. And finally, to say about ChemiFlock. ChemiFlock is an Irish manufacturing and distribution centre for portable and effluent water treatment chemicals. An Irish indigenous company in operation since 1981. It employs 28 people in its plant in Shannon, County Clare. There we go. So there's a problem with that.
Well, they could be better employed.
They could, yeah.
Dave, who was the Minister for Health at that time in 2007? Was it Mary Harney?
Harney, yeah.
Can we ring them again?
The water.
We stopped the truck delivering what we believe is dangerous water chemicals. So
that's fine. Water treatment.
We're now, yeah. We're now.
Well, why does it say on the van? It says water treatment.
That office is in Cork. It's got nothing to do with this site. It's a separate part of India. We have nothing to do with it here.
But your company puts chemicals in our water, did it? That's
no,
true.
We don't.
But you would say, why do you have water treatment?
Can you please leave our gates or obstructing our business? We have got nothing to do.
Can you just answer some every day, why does it say water treatment?
Look,
danger. The side of the lorry that's coming
do you want me to call the police to stop you obstructing our gate? You're obstructing our gate. Well, then, can you please leave our gate? That's all I'm asking you to do.
Why does it say water?
Do you know how water treatment occurs? Have you any science background?
No, please tell me. Please teach me.
And what is your background? Who are you? Like, why should I tell you anything? I don't know what you're doing.
Fluoridate.
It doesn't want to be. I've got nothing to do with fluoridation.
We
don't have fluoride.
And how do you add to our water?
But I bet you drink it.
What are you adding to our water?
I actually have a well in my own personal circumstances.
Well, I'd like to have a well.
I lived in a town for the rest of my life and I have teeth in my head. So I'm happy with that.
Oh, very good. You're great. Now,
could you please leave our game to read us?
Okay.
We're going to be going to the High Court at the end of this month, so I hope to encourage as many people to come out on that day and to really show the world and Ireland that we are not going to be drugged with fluoride. So thanks for coming today.
Amen.
Behind, and anyone doesn't know me, I'm Ashley Fitzgibbon, also known as the Girl Against Fluoride, and I've been running this public awareness campaign since, well, last year really kind of kicked off last summer, and it's been a bit of a whirlwind. We were outside on Grafton Street.
Can you hear me?
Okay. Well, this week we're presenting in the Dáil on Wednesday, myself and Declan Waugh, the environmental scientist from Cork. We were invited by Brian Stanley, the Sinn Féin TD, who's trying to put forward a bill to ban fluoride and to make it a prosecutable offence. So because of the day that was in it, the whole abortion debate was going on, so again, you know, we didn't get a massive turnout, but a lot of female PAs came into the audience, so I think that you know, speaking to women that will obviously be concerned about the next generation, I think really the message did hit home. And the party whip for Labour, Emmett Stagg, he said that he's seen campaigns come and go into the Dáil, and you know, they just fizzle out. So he said, really, we need cross-party support now, that this isn't a political issue. So I'm just going to urge people to really start to get onto their Labour TDs in your local areas and push this forward now, because if the party whip is coming out with these claims, then we need to kind of, you know, strike while the iron is hot and make sure that this isn't going to just be forgotten about again. So if you'd like to kind of get in touch with the campaign, you can go on Facebook, The Girl Against Fluoride, and online, thegirlagainstfluoride.com. And the next step in the campaign is we're going to be taking a case to the High Court. So I'll be filing the papers to the High Court the last week of July this month. So I just really want people to get in touch, and we need to rally as many people on that day as possible and make it a massive, you know, publicity event and make sure that it's not going to be ignored any longer. So anyway, my whole thing is that inside Leinster House, I found out, you know, a few months ago from a PA of Mick Flanagan, in fact, who won't be too happy with me saying this, but it's fine, but this is going out, that they actually have the reverse osmosis filters installed in the canteen inside Leinster House. So they are, in fact, filtering their water themselves, but yet they're subjecting the whole population to a low-grade poisoning of fluoride in their water and their food. So I think that we're at a stage now where, okay, our trust is wavering and pretty much is gone for the government, and I think it's not acceptable that we're tolerating, you know, not only are we being robbed, but we're also being poisoned, and I think that's part of the reason why they're getting away with a lot of the stuff that they're doing, because people are so ill. So if anyone can, I'd advise you to stop drinking the fluoridated water. I know it can be hard due to financial constraints, but even you can get the water in Lidl, Carrie Glen, and even use that and switch to a fluoride-free toothpaste as well, because fluoride is an enzyme poison and it really does impact on your health and well-being. And you need to be as strong as possible to be able to take on all these issues. So yeah, I'm delighted to be here, and I hope that all the groups, because we're all singing from the same hymn sheet. I mean, all our issues all stem from the one source. And we just need to all come together. We're not like, oh, I'm this campaign. You know, we're all the one. It's all the same. So I'd like to see something coming together a bit quicker now. So thank you.
Marcus Howard, test 1, 2, 3.